Yeah, so what we doing today? Look, everybody is in here and ready for it. And I'm sure you guys already could tell by the title, we are making granola bars for dogs. Granola bars, trail mix bars, whatever you want to call it. We are actually getting ready to go camping this weekend, which will be Kira's very first camping trip. So if you guys want to check that out, be sure to watch for those videos and check us out over at youtube.com/snowdogsvlogs. We're going to make some granola bars to take with us camping so they can eat them while we're hiking and doing fun things. So let's get to it. So as I said, we're going camping this weekend. We're going to make the dogs some treats to take camping with us. If you haven't seen our camping videos, I'll put some playlists to those up above. Also, if you're new here, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, like this video, and share it with your friends to help us continue to grow the audience. And more treat videos? You looking for more treat videos? Up in the cards and down in the video description below. Let's get to making some granola bars for dogs. We're actually going to be making some of these for ourselves as well, but not today, not this video. Are you my little ingredient thief now? Memphis is like, I can still do that too. We know you can. We know you can. And Shelby's like, there's fruits on the table. I want nothing to do with that. First, preheat the oven to 325. Okay, so this is actually going to be a pretty easy recipe. We've already preheated our oven. We are going to need 2.5 cups of, you can either use rolled oats or rolled barley flakes. I'm actually using rolled barley flakes. Shelby is on a new diet, so I have to be a little bit stricter with what I can give her. So we're using rolled barley flakes, but like I said, you can use either. Then we will need 1.5 cups of puffed rice, which I'm just using Rice Krispies. Again, this is a treat. It's not a meal replacement, so the girls can have some Rice Krispies now and then. You want a Rice Krispie, Shelby? Shelby's gonna fall asleep over there. Here, Shelby, have a Rice Krispie. Here you go. Oh, she likes the Rice Krispies. We are going to add 1/2 cup of unsweetened coconut flakes and then 1 cup of dried fruits. Now, I'm using a mixture of blueberries and unsweetened cranberries. They're unsweetened blueberries as well, so they're just normal little dried blueberries, which I know Shelby won't eat any of these. This is gonna be a treat. You like blueberries? This is gonna be a treat I don't think Shelby's gonna eat. Look at, you can see her down there already. She's like, I cannot believe you are making these treats with all of these fruits in them. Can you guys even see her? I can't tell in the camera. I think Kira's sitting in front of her. Well, she has a look of disgust. And then we're gonna just gently mix all of these dry ingredients together. Okay, so now that we have all of our dry ingredients mixed together, we're gonna mix together our wet ingredients. So basically, I'm sure you've had granola bars before. This is kind of the base of granola bars. You can use this recipe and make it for yourself. You really could eat this if you want to. It's gonna be pretty good. The only thing I'm not really adding a lot of is sugar, but I am using maple syrup and honey, and both of those are a little bit sweet. Again, treat, not a meal replacement. The dogs aren't gonna just mow these down. So these will actually be pretty good for people as well. So the next thing we're going to need is 1/2 cup of honey. I'm using Michigan honey because we're from Michigan. Would you like to try some honey? It's sticky, I know, it's sticky stuff. Kira's like, whoa, let me try that. A little bit of honey. Is it sticky? It's sticky stuff, huh? How about you, Shelby? You wanna try some honey? Shelby's like, you're making treats with fruit. I don't wanna try none of that. And then we're gonna need 1/2 cup of maple syrup. What? I know, these are gonna be a little sweeter than you're used to. And then the last ingredient is about 1/3 cup of peanut butter. Make sure you're using peanut butter that does not contain xylitol. You guys should all know that by now. But every time I make a treat video, you're all like, don't use the peanut butter that has the bad stuff in it. We know. It says, wait, there's peanut butter? This is for Shelby. She didn't get none of the rest of it. Y'all go wait. Let Shelby lick that spoon. Oh, big lick from Shelby. She's like, I like peanut butter, guys. I do like that. Now we're going to take all of the stickiness and we're going to pop this in the microwave for 1.5 minutes power. Basically, we want to warm this up so we can stir it all together so that we can then pour it over top of this. So that's what we're going to do next. While that's heating up real quick, I should have said this at the beginning, but we are going to use a 9x13 pan with some parchment paper. We're going to go ahead and kind of push this down, and then we're going to spray it so stuff doesn't stick to it, if I can spray it. So This mixture doesn't really need to be hot or boiling or anything like that. You just want it to kind of mix together. You don't want to cook it too high because you don't want everything to burn. So now we're going to take this mixture and we're going to pour it into here. Now we're going to kind of just stir this up. Try to get that stuff all over the place. We're going to bring this over here. We're going to take this pan and we're going to pour all this stuff in here and not make a giant mess. Maybe we'll make a giant mess. I'm sure we'll make a giant mess. It's kind of what we do. Okay, so now we're going to flatten this out into this pan. We're going to kind of want to get it pretty even. I'm going to do it with a spatula first. And then I'm going to do it with my hands a little bit. Okay, maybe I should have used oil and not the bakey stuff that I have. Oh wait, I can fix this. Hey, want some? Want some? See, I fixed it. All right, go wash my hands. So now we have our granola bars in the pan. We're gonna put these in the oven for probably around 25 to 30 minutes before we take them out. The reason I left the parchment paper kind of hanging over the end is when they're all done and cooled, we'll be able to just pull this right out here and then cut them. And I'm gonna cut them into squares, not bars. I'm gonna cut them into little pieces. Because as I said, these are gonna be a treat for them. They don't need to be huge. We're gonna make little ones. Try and make sure it's all even. Look, I got it in my hand again. Of course I did. That's what we do. All right, so we're gonna go put this in the oven and see how they turn out. What do you think? Shelby's like, I'm out. You made stuff with fruit in it. I don't want stuff with fruit in it today. That's okay, these two are still here. Into the oven at 325 it goes. All right, so that's what they look like. We let them cool completely before we cut them into pieces, and I think we have some interested dogs. All three of them came in here as I was cutting them, so I think they may be interested to see what they taste like. Even Shelby seems a little interested. What do you think, Shelby? You gonna want to try it? We'll see. We'll see. Shelby, the real test. I know you'll eat anything and you'll eat anything. All right, let's let them try them. So for those of you wondering, this is actually the size I cut them into for my dog. So just little, like, what, 1.5 inch by 1.5 inch squares. And they're not super thick, and that is the size that we will cut them all into and take them with us to go camping. Hey, wait your turn. All right, so here's the real test. Will Shelby eat it? What do you think? Here, I'll set it down so you can check it out. She's like, guys, there is like fruits and vegetables in there. There's no vegetables in it, just fruit. Nope, Shelby says no. She says, forget it, I'm out. Memphis says, guys, I will literally eat anything. You'll eat it. Is it crunchy? Is it good? Memphis approves. Memphis says, I will eat it all. I approve. Sit. Good girl. Here you go. What do you think? Good stuff? Guys, this is amazing. I love it. It's the greatest. You like it? It's a win? So we got two dogs say yes, one dog says no. We'll call that a 2/3 win. Good stuff? All right, go run around now. I know that's what you want. Now that you've seen everybody else eat it, now you might try it? No. All right, hold on. Well, she's thinking about it. We'll let her take her time. Maybe that's all she needs. Don't bother her. We had to put the puppy outside so the puppy don't bother her. She'll take her time and slowly munch on it. Yeah, she's thinking about it. She's gonna lick it first. All right, you lick it first and tell us what you think later. Well, we gave her a little bit of alone time and she actually did eat it. I brought Memphis out here and Shelby decided to eat it. So maybe she did like it. She just didn't like it at first. So we're gonna take those treats up camping with us. Again, if you guys wanna check out our camping videos, I will put some links up in the cards above and down in the video description below. You can check those out. You can also follow us over at youtube.com/snowdogsvlogs to see more of our day-to-day lives. These girls are ready to play. All right, you guys, we hope you enjoyed today's video. If you have suggestions for the next treat we should make, leave them down in the comments below. And you never know, we just might make your suggested treat video next. What are you doing? All right, you guys, as always, thanks so much for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Stay positive. Dream big. And we will see you again soon. Goodbye, audience. They're being crazy over there.
a snow dog. Sing a song with your sweet voice. I know you'll be.